Yes, sir. So this is, I hope you can see the slides. So this is the last lecture slides that we discussed. But here, so basically we discuss what are musical sounds. And so musical sounds are strongly regular. Like most of the sounds that we can hear, like from here I can, I can hear a lot of sounds. The birds are making various sounds outside this room, and then the vehicles and wind blowing and many different sounds, right? So most of these sounds are not regular. Right. So then, sorry, I was disconnected. I hope you can hear me now. Right, so I was explaining that so there are a lot of sounds that we can hear. Right, like outside there are a lot of sounds like birds, vehicles, and the wind. In the middle of all these sounds, most of these sounds are irregular, right? Not regular. So in the middle of that, I'm talking, right? Like sometimes some sounds which are regular, but there's a question that whether they can be considered as musical. So maybe that, like my talking would be regular, but it cannot be considered as musical. So there are some questions like what is musical and what is not. So we talk about that, right? So even the musical sounds, we have there are several frequencies. So again, sorry for the disconnection. I was disconnected again, so I changed my Wi-Fi. So now I'm in at the university. So here, sometimes there are problems with the Wi-Fi connection. In the lecturer's building, so the Wi-Fi connection is not good. So unfortunately, I changed it to my personal Wi-Fi connection here. So I think it will be fine now, right? Right. So we talked about consonants and dissonants. It is. In some musical sounds are considered as more musical than others, more pleasant than others. So that concept is there, right? But all these different sounds are used in music creatively, right? So that's for example, we have different genre, or we have different styles of music, different styles based on the countries, Sri Lankan folk music, and then Japanese folk music, Indian folk music, then different the Western music style, and then Indian classical, North Indian classical, Hindustani musical style. Like different styles are there. So these sounds are used in these different styles, different. So those are the, we can consider how these sounds are used. That's the unique feature to a musical styles. For example, different music genres, like even in a Western style, so they have classical music, and then later on, so we have jazz, blues, and then rock and roll. So these different styles use these concepts different in a different way in most of the cases, right? So then pitch classes and notes. Like in music, so we use notes basically. So what are notes actually? So notes are, so before that, let's start with frequency. Like frequency, so we talk about frequency. So it is the number of vibrations per unit time, right? Number of vibration for a given time. 1 second, how many vibrations? Right, so this is, so in these two cases, the frequency of the first signal is higher than the second signal. Right, the frequency is high, this one. This is low frequency. So number of vibrations. So suppose this is just 1 second of time. Again, this is 1 second of time, right? The number of vibrations are different. So the frequency, so frequency can be identified by identified by our ear. So there's a special organ, right? Like that snail-like organ. So it is responsible for identifying these frequencies. So if it is high frequency, we identify it as high sound. Not volume, but high pitch sound. So high pitch. So the pitch is related to frequency, right? Pitch. So the frequency is the physical aspect, right? It is a, so even we are not there, the frequency is there. That concept is there. Right, but pitch is how we identify those frequencies. Some frequencies we identify as high, right? So for example, like if we take some singers, like for example, the Sri Lankan singers, so we have like Lata Valpola, like she, her voice is so mostly she sings high frequency sounds, like high pitch, so we call high pitch. But when we take some other singer, like Amarasiri Piris, for example, like he has a he can sing low pitch sounds, low frequency, right? So pitch is how we identify frequencies by our ear, right? So pitch is like if we compare frequency and pitch, so frequency is, it is physical, right? It's physically in a sound wave or any other wave or signal, we can identify the frequency. It's a physical aspect. But pitch is, when we talk about pitch, so there should be, there have to be a person, right? I'll draw the ear, right? So that's what is important, right? When this sound is identified, the frequency is identified by our ear. So that is pitch. That's frequency. That's the difference. Otherwise, the conceptually, it is the same. The idea is the same, but the perspective is different. බලන විදිහ අනුව පිච් එක කියලා කියන්නේ අපි ඒක අඳුරන ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එක කොහොමත් මිනිස්සු නැතත් කොහේ හරි සවුන්ඩ් එකක් ජෙනරේට් වෙනවා නම් ෆිසිකලි එතන ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එකක් තියෙනවා ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි කියන අදහස තියෙනවා ඒ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි කියන අදහස ඒ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි කියන එක අපේ කන අඳුර ගන්න එක අනේ ඒක අනුව තමයි පිච් එක right? So based on that, so we have something called pitch classes. So pitch classes, pitch classes. So pitch is how frequency is identified by our ear. So here, as explained here, frequency and pitch describe the same thing, but from different viewpoints. While frequency measures the cycle rate of the physical waveform, pitch is how high or low is sound. When you hear it, how we identify it. Pitch is a perceptual property of sound that allows their ordering on a frequency related scale. So when we put the frequencies in a line, right? So 20 hertz, right? So up to 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz, right? So we usually we call 20 to 20, 20 kilohertz. This one, 20 kilohertz. So any sound that we hear can be put somewhere, right? මොකක්ද සවුන්ඩ් එක කියවුණා මේ සවුන්ඩ් එකේ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එක මෙන්න මේක කියලා අපිට දාන්න පුළුවන්. අතර මේක ඊට වඩා ටිකක් කම්ප්ලිකේටඩ්. It is a little bit complicated than that, but anyway, so we can put it there. If we hear a pure sound, just pure frequency, one frequency, so we can put that. So okay, so this sound's frequency is 400 hertz. Right, you can put that. So those are frequencies. So similarly, our ear can identify these frequencies as pitch. Like for example, if we hear this sound, 400 hertz, right? Okay, so we feel it is middle pitch sound, for example, right? So then we hear sound for example, 1000 hertz. So then when we hear that, so we hear, okay, so that sound, the pitch is higher than the previous one. So we identify it as the higher pitch than the previous one. The calling sound එකට වඩා මේක ටිකක් උඩින් නේද කියලා වගේ අපිට තේරෙන්නේ. සමහර වෙලාවට අපි පොඩක් අර මේ සින්දු කියද්දි එහෙම ඒක ඊට වඩා තාචුට උඩින් කියන්න බැරිද කියලා වගේ අහන්න සමහර. එතකොට මේ පිච් එක ඊට වඩා වැඩි කරලා. හරි. අනේ ඒ වගේ දැන් මේ මේ සවුන්ඩ් එක මේ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එකේ ලෙවල් එක the level of frequency is identified as pitch. So generally we have a scale like in our ear. So different frequencies are identified in different places. Different frequencies are detected in the different places. Right. So that's how we identify pitch, right? So then we call them pitch classes. Pitch classes. So this one pitch class, right? Like so we can identify some ranges, right? This range is one pitch, and then next range likewise. So we call them pitch classes, right? Then we can give names to those pitch classes, like for example, like we give like C D, like the A B C D E F. So in if you take Indian. And based on that Indian style, like even in Sri Lanka, like we use a sari, gama, likewise. And if we take Western style, they have like do, re, mi, like twice. The same idea, right? So pitch classes, right? We call them pitch classes. But in this pitch identification, so there's something very very special, right? So when we listen to one particular frequency, then we identify it as a one pitch. Then for example, let's say 440, then if we double the frequency, right, that means 880 hertz, then we hear this sound as higher pitch. However, the other things are similar. Like, for example, the මේ මෙතනදී ඇහෙන සද්දෙම ඒ වගේම එකක් තමයි මෙතනදී ඇහෙන්නේ. හැබැයි ඊට වඩා high pitch. So that's something very, very interesting in music. So if we give, for example, if we give C for this sound, then again, like if we double the frequency, it is again C. But we give like this is the next set of pitch classes. This is one set of pitch classes, and then when we double, so we can find the other. I mean, so if we listen in keyboard, in I'm pretty sure you have seen keyboards. So if we play. C note, right? Then, so you can find another C note, usually several keys after that, right? Keyboard එකේ then එක note එකක් ගත්තාම ඒක C, ඊට පස්සේ ආපහු C note එකක් තියෙනවා. Make up C. Both are C. So the usually in the standard tuning, the frequency of this C note is doubled in the next C note. Right? The frequency is double. Right? So this is, this is one very, very interesting thing in musical pitches. So usually we call this interval is called octave. Right. තොර සාමාන්‍ය අපි දැන් අර සමහරවිට ඔය සිංගලෙන් කියනෝනේ මේ ස්වර හතක් තියෙනවා ස්වර හතක්. ඒතර ස්වර හත ඒක තමයි ආපහු රිපීට් වෙන්නේ. දැන් අපිට මොකක් හරි සද්දයක් සවුන්ඩ් එකක් ඇහෙද්දී අපිට දැනෙන ඒ ෆීල් එක තියෙනවානේ. අන්නේ ෆීල් එක දැන් අපි මේ මෙන්න මේ 440 කියන තැන ඒ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එක අපිට ඇහෙද්දී එන ෆීලිං එකමයි. එන්න මේ ඒක ඩබල් වෙද්දී ඇහෙන. Right. එතකොට අපිට දැන් මෙතන මේ තියෙන දැන් ඒ අතර තියෙන නෝට්ස් මෙන්න මේ ටිකෙන් අපිට මොනවද ප්ලේ කරොත් ඒ ටිකම ප්ලේ කරන්න පුළුවන් ඊළඟ මෙන්න මෙතනින් තියෙන ඒ නෝට්ස් ටික. Right. ඒක මේ අර සප්තකය කියලා දැන් සිංහලෙන් නම් කියන්නේ සප්තකය කියලා කියන්නේ ස්වර සප්තකය. එතකොට දැන් මෙන්න මේක තමයි මේ මියුසික් වල තියෙන විශේෂම දේ. හරි. එතකොට මේ එක දැන් එක ස්කේල් එකක් ඊට පස්සේ අපිට ඒකම ඊට උඩින් සිං කරන්න පුළුවන්. එහෙම නැතුව අපි දැන් ගත්තොත් එහෙම දැන් මෙතන තියෙන ඕනම නෝට් එකක් ගත්තොත් ඒ නෝට් එකේ ඉඳලා මෙන්න මේ දැන් මේ හඬින් එන ඒ ෆීල් එක අපිට මේ මේ දැන් මොකක් හරි නෝට් හතක් ගත්තොත් මේ හතක් හරි හතක් අරගෙන ඊට පස්සේ අටවෙනි එක ඔන්න ඔය ඔය සෙට් එක හැම වෙලාවෙම එක අර මේ මෙන්න මේ මේක ගත්තොත් එහෙම අපි ඔක්ටේව් එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ අනේ ඒ ඒ රේන්ජ් එකේ තියෙන pitch classes pitch classes set so we can identify similarities between these seven so if you take any seven notes so we can identify some similarities right yani hatakata passe ilagata ena eka ara kalin ara gahapu mul ekka wage ara eka me me ara ikama de repeat wevi yana wage ekak tiyena hari and make the music wala tiyena vishesha lakshanayak so it is something interesting in pitch is perceptual property of sound that allows their ordering on a frequency related scale right this frequency related scale could be different it is subjective right it could be different from how I depending on my perception it could be different than others right it is subjective to the person who listen to that sound so based on I mean there are not many big difference but there could be slight differences ekena pitch ekak dan api mokak hari frequency ekak a eka menne me pitch ekak kiyala api identify karagaddi eka wenas wenna puluwa mama perceive karana vidiyai wenek kenek perceive karana vidiyai it is little bit subjective because it is perceptual property it's not a physical property pitch is not physical property so in music a pitch class is a set of all pitches that are all number of octave apart sorry octave this is the so here like so this is the TAVES okay i ekak naha octave apart example the pitch class c consists of the c's in all octaves right so as I told you so there's a c here and then there is another c after double the frequency api frequency ka double karoth etana apahu c ekak tiyena ehema nan menne me neme c kiyanne eken pitch classes etara c ekak metanak tiyena me c ekak metanak tiyena hari so usually we name them this is usually C4 this is C5 likewise so we name them so based on their positions in in a standard ways, a standard piano. So piano keyboard, based on their position, we name them, right? Okay. So pitch classes කියලා කියන්නේ දැන් C කියලා කියන්නේ pitch class එක. ඒතර C notes තියෙනවා keyboard එක ගත්තොත් එහෙම keyboard එකේ තැන් තැන් වල C notes තියෙනවා. ඒතර ඒ C කියලා කියන්නේ pitch class එක. The pitch class C consists of the C's in all octaves. ඔක්ටේව් එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ අර ස්වර හතක සෙට් එක. ස්වර හතේ සෙට් එකේ තියෙන ස්වර ටික pitch classes ඒ ස්වර හතෙන් හතට ඒ විදිහටම තියෙනවා. හරි. Musical note is a symbol denoting a musical sound. In English usage, a note is also the sound itself. The note එකක් කියලා අපි කියන්නේ එක pitch class එකකට pitch class musical note it is the same idea pitch class then in keyboard we have notes right for example this note C and then the next C so both are in the same pitch class but two notes notes දෙකක් C කියලා කියන්නේ notes දෙකක් හැබැයි pitch class කියන අදහසෙන් ගත්තොත් ඒ දෙක එකම pitch class එක මේකත් C මේකත් C right a note can also represent a pitch class note එකකින් pitch class එක represent කරන්න පුළුවන් හැබැයි ඒ දෙක අදහස් දෙකක් right right so then melody and harmony melody a sequence of individual musical notes played one after the other this makes song recognizable sequence of individual musical notes right අපි note set එකක් play කරා කියලා කියන්නේ නිකන් keyboard එකේ piano keyboard එකේ අපි නිකන් එහෙම play කරොත් එහෙම a sequence a note api fill pay karapu me note sequence eka eka melody ekama hari edara eka it won't be a good melody but anyway it is a melody right harmony so harmony is two or more musical notes being played at the same time So harmony, in harmony we play multiple notes at the same time. We play or we sing multiple notes, right? So it could be in keyboard we can play multiple notes. If we are singing, so we cannot at the same time in usual manner we cannot play the same note. So then in that case multiple people would be singing together so then we can create harmony right so if we take a guitar so we can play multiple notes multiple sounds at the same time right so when we play chords means we play multiple sounds at the same time chords right harmony then rhythm so rhythm is how the musical notes are laid out through time So rhythm is like we play multiple music notes, right? So we play A note, so then B note, C note, D note, and so on, right? Then, so if we do that in a different manner, like A and then B, C, D. So suppose this is the time, right? Again, this is the time. If we play these two melodies, they will sound different, right? Because the time would be different. කියලා දැන් මෙතන මේ time එක අඩුයි. අපි හැබැයි මෙතනදී ඊට වඩා A play කළා time එක තව පොඩ්ඩක් ගිහිල්ලා තමයි B එක. සමහරට A අතරේ මේ 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 A play කරගෙන ඉන්නවා කියලා හිතන්න. හරි. So even so we have same sequence of notes, but the final output or the final effect would be different because of the rhythm, right? How musical notes are laid out through time. It's about how long a note is and how long it takes for the next note to be played. तो मैं टाइमिंग ගැන කතා කරද්දී rhythm. So when we play music, we play frequencies, right? We play frequencies. Then we play that frequencies. So based on the time. So how those frequencies are placed in the timeline. මේ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි එක ප්ලේ කරද්දී කොහොමද මේ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි ප්ලේ කරන්නේ? මේ ෆ්‍රීකවන්සි සීක්වන්ස් එකක් අපි ප්ලේ කරන්නේ. එතකොට පිච් සීක්වන්ස් එකක් ප්ලේ කරන්නේ. එමෙතන නෝට් සීක්වන්ස් එක. ඒක කොහොමද ටයිම් එකත් එක්ක arrange කරන්නේ? අන්න ඒක තමයි රිද්ම් එකෙන් කරන්නේ. So rhythm does the rhythm is adding the timing into the music. Right, so so we call it duration as well, right? So in music, duration is an amount of time or how long or short a note, phrase, section or composition lasts. So duration is the timing basically. The duration is the length of time a pitch or tone is sounded. Yeah, it is the same idea. The concept of duration can be further broken down into those of beat and meter, and where beat is seen as a constant and the rhythm being longer, shorter or the same length as the beat, right? The beat. So if you take the beat and the rhythm, so let's talk about the difference here. The beat is the steady pulse that you feel in the tune, like a clock stick. It is the beat you naturally clap along to or tap your foot to. So when you listen to a music, so you can clap, right? So when you listen to the music, you tap or you clap, right? So based on like this, so when for any music or any song, you clap. So that's the beat, like this, right? The rhythm is the actual sound or time value of note, which is in a sound would also be same as a word. So this is often a measure in beats per minute, right? So the rhythm, like beat is like this, beat. So this is beat. So then I can put those beads like this. Oh. So I think you can hear this, right? So the rhythm is how many beats per minute? Beats kiyak enawada minute ekata BPM. So we measure the rhythm using this BPM. Beats kiyak tiyenawada නැහැ. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ මියුසික් එක වේගෙන් යනවද හිමීට යනවද කියන එක තමයි රිද්ම් එක කියලා කියන්නේ. හරි. අපිට එකම මියුසික් සින්දුව ප්ලේ කරන්න පුළුවන් වේගෙන් ප්ලේ කරන්න. හරි. දැන් අපි මොකද රැප් මියුසික් එකක් ගත්තොත් දැන් අපි ගමුකෝ නිකන් අර මේ වාත්‍ය සන්තෝෂ්ණක් කියන සීරි සංගබුද්ධි මාලිගාවේදී ඒක දැන් ඒක කියද්දී දවගටි සමහර දැකලා ඇති ඒකත් කිය රිද්ම් එක වැඩි කරනවා එන්නේ හරි ඒතර කියන්නේ දැන් මුලින්ම ඒ කට්ටිය නිකන් හිමීට හිමීට කියනවා ඊට පස්සේ එන්නේ රිද්ම් එක වැඩි කරනවා ඒතර ඒ බීට්ස් ගන්න වැඩි ඒතර ඒකට ඉක්මනට ඉක්මනට කියනවා ඒ කියන්නේ එක බීට් එකකට එන මේ නෝට්ස් ටික දිනවා ඒක ඉක්මනට ඉක්මනට කියනවා මේ බීට් එකේ වෙලා ඊළඟ බීට් එක යද්දි අර කියන්න ඕන ටික කියන්න. So number of beats per minute BPM. So if we take 60 BPM means speed of 1 beat per second. අපර එකට එක ගන්න. බීට්. කියනවා නම් ඒක 60 BPM. So the timing, right? So this is a duration. It is totally about timing. In timing, we have two concepts: the beat and then the rhythm. Beats per minutes. So then we have another concept: timbre. Or timbre, so we call like timbre or timbre, right? So timbre would be much better in music. So timbre also known as tone color or tone quality is the perceived sound quality of a musical note, sound or tone, right? So the timbre is so we talk about pitches. So pitch, it is related to the frequency, right? Then notes, pitch classes, notes, and then melody and harmony, and then timing, right? So same melody can be played in different timing, different rhythms, yeah, and then you play the same melody or the same note in the same duration, right? Same rhythm using two instruments, right? Ekama melody eka ekama rhythm eken play karana kiyala hitanna instruments deka ke etakota apita ahenne apita andura ganne so we can identify two different instruments. So this is piano, and then we can identify this is violin, right? Sometimes you don't know the instrument, but you know so this is different instrument. So how we identify that? So that is the timbre, right? This color of the sound. The color of the sound, it is depending on the waveform. If you play the same thing using different instruments, it could be voice, flute, violin, same thing, but the waveform is different. Hey, me waveform එක වෙනස් වෙන්නේ. Can anyone guess why these waveforms are different in different instruments, including voice? දැන් එකම සින්දුව කියද්දී හිතන්න දැන් කියනවා කියලා මේ ශ්‍රියා ഘോഷල් සින්දුව කියනවා එකම සින්දුව ඊට පස්සේ අපි කිතමු මේ තව වෙන සිංහ කෙනෙක් අපි තුමු ලංකාවේ කෙනෙක් ශෂිකා නිසංසලා ඒ සින්දුවම කියනවා දැන් අපිට අඳුර ගන්න පුළුවන් මේ 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 ශ්‍රියා ഘോഷල් මේ ශෂිකා නිසංසලා We identify it using that waveform. A waveform make vidhyanu hai anti adruga. A waveform make venas hai ne bhoomada. Let's keep that voice the two singers apart. Let's talk about like flute and violin. How we identify? Flute and violin. Why these are different? Anyone?
Because of tone.
Yes, tone. So how it is happened, Akalanga? So physically, how could it be occurred?
Everything has a unique tone. So when if we didn't hear that tone before, we can't identify proper.
Yeah. So if we haven't listened to that one, we cannot identify. But we can identify the difference. It is. Like it is different, right? So the reason for this one, I'm pretty sure you know this. When sound is generated in flute, and sound is generated in violin, the mechanism is different, right? The violin එකක් ගත්තොත් violin එකේ sound එක generate වෙන mechanism එක වෙනස්නේ. එතකොට එකම frequency එක generate වෙද්දී ඒකට තව එකතු වෙන frequencies වෙනස්. So as I told you, general sounds, it is a combination of frequencies, not just one frequency. It's a combination of frequencies. Why it is a combination of frequencies? Because when sound is generated, there are the main frequencies there, but then the reflections of that frequency, it could be in the strings, in the other strings and the body, there are many reflections. Those things would be added in the final sound it is generated. Can you sound එක දැන් අපි guitar එකක් ගත්තොත් එහෙම guitar එකේ string එක මෙයා වෙනවා. ඊට පස්සේ string එකෙන් සමහරට මේ පොඩ්ඩක් අනිත් string වලට චුට්ටක් මෙයා වෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඊට පස්සේ guitar එකේ body එක guitar එක කියන්නේ ඇතුලේ මේ තියෙනවනේ අර දැන් lee වලින් හදපු guitar එකක් නම් ඒ lee වල ඒක ඇතුලේ වැදිලා ඒ මේ গিටාර් එකේ ඇතුලේ තියෙන හැඩය අනුව තැන් තැන් වල වැදිලා එන මේ මේ ඒතර රිෆ්ලෙක්ට් වෙලා ඒ ජෙනරේට් වෙනවත් මේකට එකතු වෙනවා හරි ඊට පස්සේ දැන් අපි ෆ්ලූට් එකක් ගත්තොත් ෆ්ලූට් එකේ අපි මේ දැන් ෆ්ලූට් එකේ දැන් එක එක දිග ෆ්ලූට්ස් තියෙනවානේ ෆ්ලූට් එකේ එතකොට ඒ වායු කඳ කම්පණය වෙන විදිය වෙනස් වෙනවා එතකොට ඒක ඇතුලේදී කොයි විදිහටද ඒවා ආපහු රිෆ්ලෙක්ට් වෙලා මේ එකට එකතු වෙන මේ මේ අර මේ මේ additional frequencies අපි කියමු overtones කියලා. ඒ overtones ප්‍රමාණය වෙනස් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. overtones වල power එක වෙනස් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ ඒ හින්දා තමයි මෙන්න මේ sound එක වෙනස් වෙන්නේ. දැන් උදාහරණයක් විදිහට දැන් මගේ කටහඬ තීරණය වෙන්නේ මගේ උගුරේ තියෙන හැඩේ. ඊට පස්සේ මගේ මේ මේ උගුරේ විතරක් නෙවෙයි මගේ නහයේ කටේ උගුරේ ඒ තියෙන හැඩ. ඊට පස්සේ මේ දැන් සොරාලේ සොර ඒකේ තියෙන වෙනස්කම්. ඒ වගේම තමයි මේ 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 දැන් මට ආවේනික හඬක් එන්නේ එහෙම. Right? දැන් එතකොට දැන් අපි ඇත්තරම දැන් ඔය ඒක තමයි සවුන්ඩ් එකේ කලර් එක කියලා කියන්නේ. කලර් එක කැරක්ටර් එක. So any ඇත්තරම මේ අකලංක as you said it is a tone. Tone is different. Tone එක different කියලා කියන්නේ අන්නේ ඒක තමයි ඒ කැරක්ටර් එක. So that's why sometimes like we so I am from 80s and 90s so that's the time that I was grown up. So the music at that time and the earlier music like they used so mostly they used the acoustic sounds like real instruments but nowadays after 2000 and actually even in our module that we are doing so we are generating music with the computer right. So when we generate music with computer, that different tone colors could be lost. So that's a one important thing that you have to remember, right? So we are generating music using computers. Like sometimes we are recording and then generating, but there are a lot of things that we can do with computers. In that case, so you have to remember, if you are into music, always try to preserve that tone, colors, that character. So in most of the current music, contemporary music, especially popular music, the character is lost, right? So that character is in timbre. So this is when sound is generated, so the mechanism would be different from even there are two flutes, the sound would be different. Right, because their dynamics would be different. Ekena dange flute dekak unata ekama vidhiya unata samahalata e deke hane podi wenasak tiyenna puluwan e tone eke wenasak tiyenna. Me deka hadala tiyana dewal anu eke athule tiyana ida pramana anu e wage podi wenasak tiyenna puluwan. Right, so that's timbre. So usually the modern music research there are a lot of research going on classification, different classifications, like for example music genre classification, automatic genre classification. When music signal is given, so we can identify which genre this music is belongs to. Ekena music ekak mokotada classical music ekakda meka ema naththam ekak jazz ekakda ema naththam me hindustani classical ekakda mokari yanne hema apita style ekak anduraganna then me timbre kiyana ekak loku udawwak wenna puluwan. Ekena music then අපි ජෑස් මියුසික් වල ප්ලේ කරන ඉන්ස්ට්‍රුමන්ට්ස් නෙවෙයි අපි ප්ලේ කරන්නේ මේ සමහරට බ්ලූස් වගේ ගත්තත් ඒක තිය සමානයි අපි ගත්තොත් මේ රොක් ඇන් රෝල් සහ ජෑස් ගත්තොත් මේ දෙකේ අපි පාවිච්චි කරන ඉන්ස්ට්‍රුමන්ට්ස් වෙනස් ගොඩක් ඉතින් ඉන්ස්ට්‍රුමන්ට්ස් වලින් අපිට පුළුවන් මේ මේ සමහරට අඳුරගන්න මේ මේ මොන ස්ටයිල් එකද කියලා ඒක ඒ කියන්නේ එක මේ එකක් විතරයි තව දේවල් ගන්න පුළුවන් tempo right so this is one important concept right so then we talked about the digital audio workstation right so these are some names that I have given right then so this week right so this is this week we are talking about audio technology right so in last lecture so we talk about some concepts musical the concepts in music right so with the so those are just fundamentals right like if you talk about a pitch and then pitch classes there are many things like if you talk about chords like music theory is there right like music theory so I'm not going to talk about music theory here right so how notes like what are notes and pitches and then pitch classes and then so how chords are generated what are the chords and then those things and many other things music theory is there so I'm not going to talk about those here I have just given very basic introduction right because like in audio production so most of the audio productions are directed into musical audio musical production api eken then eken loke music audio production killa kiwama me thawa dewal thiyena api eken api gattot mokkari then film එකක background score එක කියලා කිව්වොත් එහෙම ඒකේ තියෙනවා music වලට අමතර තව දේවල් ඊට පස්සේ ඒකේ දැන් sound production තියෙනවා ඒ කියන්නේ එක එක sounds කොහොමද generate කරන්නේ ඒ වගේ දේවල් තියෙනවානේ හැබැයි ගොඩක්ම audio production කියලා කිව්වොත් music production කියන පැත්ත තමයි ඒ කියන්නේ මේ ඒ පැත්තට තමයි ගොඩක් දේවල් තියෙන්නේ එකනේ ඔඩියෝ ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් කියලා මියුසික් ප්‍රොඩක්ෂන් තමයි කරෙන්නේ හැබැයි ඊට අමතරව ඔඩියෝ තව ඔඩියෝ කියන්නේ මියුසික් විතරක් නෙමෙයි as I told you most of the sounds are not music right so එහෙනම් මියුසික් තියරි කියන එක වෙනම එකක් තව ඒකේ දේවල් තියෙනවා මම නිකන් බේසික් ඉන්ට්‍රොඩක්ෂන් එකක් දුන්නේ වැඩ කරගෙන යන්න පුළුවන්. Then today so we have to talk about audio technology. In audio technology how music or how sounds are represented electrically. Right? But nowadays it is digital how sound is represented digital so we have to learn that so this is very important if you work with any audio production like if you work, like usually nowadays we work with digital audio. In that case, this is very important, right? So audio is made of electrical energy that represents sound using either changing levels of electrical voltage for analog signals or a series of binary numbers for digital signals. So in when we talk about audio, so there are two types, analog and digital. So audio is basically electrical energy. So in that case, in analog, it could be changing levels of electrical voltage. Voltage change in the aching represent karan pulan sound ke venaska. So we call them analog signals. Analogs are continuous, right? If we represent sound like this with the time, right? This is the time, continuous time, right? Time එකත් එක කොහොමද amplitude එක වෙනස් වෙන්නේ, right? So usually if we take a real sound, it would be something like this. This is the time our amplitude is change. This is continuous time, right? Like if we take, right? This is 0 seconds, right? This is 1 second. So in between this 1 second, so we can identify, I mean, all the times between these 0 and 1 are here. Can you maybe hammer time? Then අපි time interval එකක් ගත්තොත් ඒ හැම time interval එකටම මේ sound එකේ තියෙනවා representation. So there's a representation for each time interval. ඒ කියන්නේ අපි ගත්තොත් එහෙම මොකක් හරි time එකක් ඕනෙම time එක any time, if we take any time, so there's a representation for that time. Analog signal, in analog signal. But in digital signal, it is different. Time it is not continuous time. So we have time intervals. Just like times, right? Like this, right? But actually it is something like this, something like this. It is like an array, right? So this time, what is the amplitude? The next time, what is the amplitude? So likewise, in each time interval, tappara ekedi dekedi thunedi like athama tappara nevey eka ita wada podi level ekki tiyenne komari ekena den api gattot ehema me time ලයින් එකේ ඕනම ටයිම් එකක් හරි මොකක් හරි එක ටයිම් එකක් ඒ හැම ටයිම් එකටම අරක රිප්‍රසන්ටේෂන් එකක් නැහැ we don't have a representation for any time that we select from the timeline දැන් මෙතන නම් අපි ගත්ත ඕනම අපි මෙතන ඕනම තැනක් select කරොත් ඒකට representation එකක් තියෙනවා මෙන්න මෙතන මේ value එක so this is the value at the time if we take this time it is like we have the representation so likewise we have representation like metana neme me metane poddak udi thora me hama time ekatama thiyena representation but in digital we don't have that like it is like this හැම එකටම මේකේ රිප්‍රසන්ටේෂන් එකක් නැහැ. සමහර මේකේ මෙතෙන්ට නැහැ. ඒක රිප්‍රසන්ට් කරන්න ඒ ළඟ යන ටයිම් එකකට තමයි. Right. So that's the difference. Analog signal it is continuous signal. Digital signal it is discrete. Signal that used to represent data as a sequence of separate values at any point in time. Any point means not all points, some selected points only. Right. So then, when we talk about this analog and digital, when we talk about audio recording, so audio recording, so the audio recording, so usually this is the evolution of audio recording. So the early days, like so we have like these old devices. Actually I never used them. Maybe some of you have used it, like a gramophone එහෙම තිබ්බේ අනේ කාලේ ඒ වගේ දේවල් පාවිච්චි කරා right so this is a gramophone record and then later the sound the audio recording was done using cassette tapes or compact cassette tapes right all of these recordings were analog right I don't know whether you have used cassette tapes but when I was little yeah I used them so that's the source of recordings that we had when we were little right like listen to listen music so then CD technology so with that it is converted into digital with CD it is digital recording This is a brief history, right? Like there are many devices in between, many technologies in between. So, but basically, this is an idea. So, digital audio. In digital audio, so in this module, we are not talk about analog. Right? So, we are going to talk about mainly digital. So we are going to produce audio using the computer so that means it is digital audio so digital audio is the system in which we store recreate and manipulate audio information in a computer system, the sound wave is converted into data through a series of snapshots, measurements, or samples. In digital audio, we have samples, right? So those are snapshots, right? So for example, like take our life, right? Take our life. So we take photographs or snapshots of different events of our life, right? Right, so when you are at school, you take a photo in your first concert, and then so there's a photo in when you did some sports in school, right? So then when you did your A levels, you went on a trip, so you have some photos. So likewise, you have snapshots in different events, right? Suppose if there's a video, right? If you could make a video of your life from beginning to end, right? ඉපදිච්ච දවස් ඉඳන් මකර කැමරා එකක් තියාගෙන ඒ කියන්නේ ඒක නිකන් අමුතු කැමරා එකක් කියලා හිතන්න. ඒ කැමරා එකෙන් දිගටම රෙකෝඩ් වෙවි තියෙනවා ඔයාගේ දේවල්. Right? It is continuous, right? දැන් එහෙම එකක් තිබ්බොත් ඒක continuous නේ. දැන් එහෙම දැන් ඒකෙදි හැම දැන් මොකක්hari දැන් මෙතන තියෙන්නේ ඔන්න මේ concert එක ඊළඟට මොකක්hari sport event එක. ඒ දෙක අතරමැද ඒව නැහැ. හැබැයි මේ video එකක් ගත්තොත් ඒ දෙක අතරමැද ඒවත් තියෙනවා. මේක analog වගේ. This is like analog. So you have a video recorded from the beginning of your life to the end. But if you take a snapshots, so this is like digital. You take only some snapshots, not all events are there, right? So sound wave, similarly, sound wave, it is continuous, right? මේ මම හැම වෙලාවෙම මේ sound wave එක මෙහෙම represent කරන්නේ. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ sound wave එකක් මේ විදිහට represent කරන්න පුළුවන් අපිට. Time එකත් එක්ක amplitude එක කොහොමද වෙනස් වෙන්නේ? ඒ වුණාට ඇත්තටම time sound signal එක මෙහෙම යන signal එකක් නෙවෙයි ඇත්තටම නේ. දැන් අපි අර කිව්ව විදිහට sound signal මේ යන්නේ ඒවා මේ අර molecules මේ vibrate වෙන්නේ මේ ඉස්සරහටයි පස්සටයි. හරි ඒ විදිහටයි වයිබ්‍රේට් වෙන්නේ. හැබැයි ඒක අපිට රිප්‍රසන්ට් කරන්න පුළුවන් මෙන්න මේ විදිහට. මේ විදිහට රිප්‍රසන්ට් කරන්න පුළුවන් ඇම්ප්ලිටියුඩ් එක වෙනස් වෙන විදිහ, right? මේ හරි. දැන් මේ විදිහට මේක කන්ටිනියස්. This is continuous. But in digital case we just get some snapshots. Likewise, we take some snapshots. This is digital. We call these snapshots samples. Right, so we call this process converting analog into digital. We making samples. It is called sampling. Sampling. samples. A sample is taken at a particular time in the audio wave recording amplitude. In given times, we take the amplitudes, right? Actually, so even this is like this. In actual representation, it is an array of numbers, right? It could be minus numbers as well, array of numbers. So like an array of numbers. මේ මේ sound එක digital sound එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ මෙන්න මෙහෙම number array එක. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මොකක් හරි music එකක් record කරලා අපි wave file එකක් විදිහට අපි මේ computer-ේ save කරගත්තා කියන්නේ. මේ wave file එක බැලුවොත් මේ wave file එකේ තියෙන මෙන්න මේ විදිහ sequence එක number sequence එක. Amplitude sequence එක. ඒක array එකක්. Each of these is called a sample. This is a sample. A sample is taken at a particular time in the waveform. This information is then converted into digestible binary data, right? So these values are converted into binary values, right? So usually this is the process: analog to digital converter, or ADC, analog to digital converter. I don't know whether you have learned this in other modules earlier, maybe in your physics or in I don't know, maybe introduction to multimedia, fundamentals of multimedia, anywhere. So you may have heard of this analog to digital, right? Then we have the reverse, digital to analog. So these are the steps of conversion. ADC converts a continuous time or continuous amplitude analog signal to discrete time and discrete amplitude, right? So there are two parts here. The first one is sampling, the next one is quantizing sampling. So first sampling, then quantizing. In analog signal, it is continuous time and continuous amplitude. This is important, huh? Continuous time and continuous amplitude. This is time is continuous. එකන මේ දෙකක් අතර හැමදේම තියෙනවා. එන ටයිම් දෙකක් ගත්තොත් ඒ දෙක අතර ඔක්කොම ටයිම් ටික මෙතන රිප්‍රසන්ට් වෙනවා. All times are represented. Similarly, all amplitudes are represented. If we take amplitude here and here, all the amplitude in between are represented. So we have, this is amplitude line. All amplitude are represented here. All times are represented here. So that's why it is called continuous time and continuous amplitude. But in a practically in computer, we cannot represent all the times and all the amplitudes. ඔක්කොම values ටික අපිට represent කරන්න බෑනේ සීමාවක්. Right? If we take an array. So there's a range. If we take a, so suppose if you have integer value, or if you have double or float value, if you take double, for example, double data type has it has a range. From double, we can represent this number to that number. So this is the range. We can represent only these. And in between that, we cannot represent all. We can represent only these values. So we have a limitation here. So that means, so we cannot represent all these. All these. අපි ගත්තොත් එහෙම මෙන්න මෙතන අපිට මෙන්න මේක අපිට represent කරන්න පුළුවන් දැන්. එතකොට මෙන්න මෙතන සමහරට ඒක represent කරන්න බෑ අපේ තියෙන data type එක අනුව. එහෙනම් ඒ ආසන්නයේ තියෙන type එකක් තමයි අපිට represent කරන්න. We may have to represent not the exact amplitude but a rounding value. So based on our limitation, we can represent only discrete amplitudes. We cannot represent all. We can represent only these amplitudes. Right? We can represent only these times. And we can represent only these amplitudes. ඒව ක්‍රොස් වෙන තැන් විතරයි අපිට රිප්‍රසන්ට් කරන්න පුළුවන්. Right. So the sampling means we find discrete times. Time එක discrete කරන එක තමයි sampling කියලා කියන්නේ. Quantization කියලා කියන්නේ quantizing කියලා කියන්නේ amplitude එක discrete කරන එක. Only given amplitudes can be represented. So for example, in this case, so we discrete time. So we use discrete time and then amplitudes are 6.5, 3.3. In this given time, the amplitudes are 6.5, 3.3, 2.0 and so on. But when it comes to quantizing, we cannot represent 6.5, for example, right? I mean, generally we can, but in this example, we can represent only 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. So in that case, we round this to a representable value, 7, 3.3, 3, 2, yeah, we can represent it. So likewise, we make discrete amplitudes. So this is what we do. And then finally, in the process, first we do sampling and then quantizing and then encoding. For these values, we give binary values. So finally, our digital music is a sequence of binary values, ones and zeros, encode. So we do these three things: sampling, quantizing, encoding. So if we do digital to analog converter, we reverse this, right? We do decoding. And then we can generate analog signal from digital. For example, when we generate music, so when we record music, we convert, when we record music or sound in a computer, we do this. Analog to digital conversion, right? Then if we play back that sound using headphones, so if using speakers, we do the opposite. digital to analog conversion. Right? When we do analog to digital, so the standard method is PCM, pulse code modulation. PCM is a standard method of digitally represent the analog. In PCM, so these are the steps: sampling, quantizing, and encode. PCM. So if you find wave file, if you buy a CD, music CD, so the music is in, it's most of the cases, it would be in a wave format. So in wave format means it is, it has pulse code modulator. It's a PCM audio, PCM mode. We call them PCM mode. Like a wave file, PCM mode. PCM කියලා කියන්නේ ඒක. Right? In sampling. So usually in sampling, so we find discrete times and we take samples of in discrete times. පළවෙනි millisecond එකේදී දෙවෙනි millisecond එකේදී යන්නේ මේ විදිහට අපි discrete times වලදී samples ගන්න. So the number of samples that we take, it is called sampling frequency or sampling rate. Number of samples per seconds. Per second. එක තප්පරයකදී සාම්පල් කීයක් අපි පාවිච්චි කරනවා. If we convert analog signal into digital, we take samples, right? If we use many samples per second, එක තප්පරයකදී samples ගොඩක් ගන්න. එතකොට ඒ තප්පරයකට එන samples ගන්න වැඩි වෙන්න අර original signal එක represent කරන්න පුළුවන් ඒ විදිහට. We can create a digital signal very closer to the original signal. Original analog signal, if you use many samples. So the number of samples or sampling rate is a measure of the quality of the digital signal. And digital signal like quality එක ගැන මෙෂර් එකක් තමයි මේ 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 sample කීයක් පාවිච්චි කරනවා. We call it sampling rate or sampling frequency. So then with the sampling frequency, so we have something called sampling interval or sampling period. Right? Again, api tapparekata gattot. So in a CD, usually in when we recording, when you are recording in CD, sampling rate is hertz. Hertz. So that means if we take 1 second of the sound, we have this number of samples. තප්පරයක් ගත්තොත් 1 second. So we have this number of frequent samples. එන මෙච්චර sample ගන්න තියෙනවා. So if we take 4 minutes of music, in this like CD standard format, then how many samples in our music? So then 1 second, this much, so then 1 minute, this much, and then 1 minute, this much, and then this number of samples are in the music. තප්පරයකට තියෙනවා මෙන්න මෙච්චර sample. ඒතර ඒ තප්පර 60යි ඒක විනාඩි 4න් වැඩි කරාම මෙන්න මෙච්චර ගානක් තියෙනවා samples අපේ එක දැන් අපි ගත්ත CD එකක අපි මේ විනාඩි 4ක සින්දුවක් record කරොත් මෙන්න මෙච්චර ගානක් තියෙනවා sample. ඒතර values මෙන්න මෙච්චර ගානක array එකක් විදිහට තමයි ඒක record වෙන්නේ. Right? Values go down. This is called frequency sampling frequency. Then sampling period means then tappare ekata menne mechchara sample godak thiyena. Ekak sample ekaka time ekak. The time duration for one sample it is this much. Right. It is called usually we, it is called FS. It is 1/T. T is the sampling interval. එක sample එකකට කොච්චර time එකක් යනවා. Sampling period. Right. Then quantization. Quantization is the process of mapping input values from large set to a smaller set, right? So in sampling, we talk about timeline, time. Time එක අනුව තප්පරයකට කොච්චර samples එනවා. Then in quantization, we talk about amplitude. How many numbers can be represented, right? How many bits can be used to represent this one value, right? මේ එක value එකක් represent කරන්න කොච්චර bits ගන්න පාවිච්චි කරනවා. So that is sometimes called bit depth, right? It's called bit depth or bit rate. So, sorry, bit resolution or bit depth. The number of available values which can be assigned is determined by the number of bits used for each sample. So that is. එතකොට කියන්නේ දැන් දැන් මේ මේකේ මොන හරි තියෙන amplitude එක අපි represent කරන්නේ values bits කීයකින්. ඒ bits කීයකින් represent කරනවාද කියන එක අනුව අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් කොච්චර වෙනස් amplitudes again අපිට තියාගන්න පුළුවන් ධන සහ ඍණ මේක එක sample වල මෙන්න මේ සමහරට මෙන්න මේක හරියටම represent කරන්න බැරි වෙන්න පුළුවන් එතකොට දැන් මෙතනදී අපි මෙන්න මේ sample එකේදී මෙන්න මේ value එක තියන මේ sample එකේදී අපිට තියාගන්න බෑ මේ ඇත්තටම තියෙන value එක මේක හැබැයි ඒක තියාගන්න බෑ ඊට ආසන්නයෙන් අපිට represent කරන්න පුළුවන් value එක තමයි So if bit depth is higher, the quality of the sound is higher. Can our original sound එක වගේම sound එකක් තියාගන්න නම් bit depth එක පුළුවන් තරම් වැඩි කරන්න. පුළුවන් තරම් වැඩි කරන්න බෑ අපිට ඒකට සීමාවන් තියෙනවා so we have the limitations for that right right so then so we have something called Nyquist Shannon sampling theorem so sometimes we call Nyquist theorem it is based on this for lossless digitization the sampling rate should be at least twice the maximum frequency responses so the idea here is to make a quality digital audio so you need your sampling rate should be double the maximum frequency so if we are representing for example human readable so human hearing system so it is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz right so this would be the maximum that we can hear right then if we want to represent if we want to make a good quality sound digital audio recording we have to have this sampling frequency the double the maximum frequency maximum frequency is 20,000 if we double it has to be 40,000 40,000 hertz so that means 40,000 samples per second is the ideal for recording human hearable sounds into digital format digitally api me record karno nan apada ahenna puluwa wedima sound ekak 20000 etara 20000 wage degunaya sampling rate ekak unoth apada quality sound ekak generate karanna puluwa kiyana menna meka thamai me Nyquist theorem ekak kiyala kiyan right so usually like we go beyond this actually in our CD quality so we have 44,100 hertz so this is the frequency sampling frequency of CD standard so that means in a CD recording we can record all the audible sounds for human ඒ කියන්නේ CD recording එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ අපිට එන ඕනෑම frequency එකක හඬක් මේකේ හොඳට මේ record කරන්න පුළුවන් because it is frequency sampling frequency is more than double the 20,000 or maximum hearable frequency so this is called Nyquist Shannon sampling theorem CD audio slightly exceed this resulting in the ability to represent bandwidth of around again bandwidth ekila kiyanne apada represent karanna puluwan e frequency range ek me wage double menne me wage double Right, so these are some sampling rates in our general use CD rate it is this value and then in video right or in for example like in movies audio is recorded using this sampling rate, 48,000. It is more high quality than CD. It has to be, right? And then, so other, for example, like in telephones, usually it is, sampling rate is 8,000. Because it is enough, right? In telephones, we are not going to sing. We are not going to listen to very, very sensitive sounds. So if we can listen to what other person is saying, that's enough, right? So this sampling rate is enough, right? So likewise, in different applications, different sampling rates are used. Right. Even in bit depth, so it is also different in different applications. See, so what are the frequencies that we can represent, and then the bit resolution. So those are. So sampling rate and bit depth. Quality of each sample, samples per second. Sampling rate take tamai determine karanne frequency range that can be recorded. Mona mona frequencies, kochchara frequency range eka අපිට රෙකෝඩ් කරන්න පුළුවන්ද කියලා sampling rate එක තමයි කියන්නේ. ඊට පස්සේ ඉන්න sample වල quality එක quality of each sample ඒක තීරණය කරන්නේ bit depth එක. Right? Okay. Right, so digital audio processing. Right? So in this case there's something called signal to noise ratio. So that means if we take a signal, right? If we take signal, so we may have, this is the part that it is important for us, right? And then, so there is noise, there could be noise in the recording. So then the important part and then the noise part, the ratio of the powers, right? Ratio is defined as the ratio of the power of signal, the meaningful input and the meaningless or unwanted input. Medeke powers wala wenasa tamai api sound to noise ratio kila SNR. And then we have some file formats, uncompressed and compressed file formats like MP3 or .ogg. So those are compressed. If you take WAV or AIFF, right? So those are uncompressed. So we are going to talk about those when we are using, when we are doing some practicals, we can talk about them as well. And then compression, we have lossless compression or lossy compression, right? So we, the quality of uncompressed audio equal to the quality of original file. Ekenne eke mokut loose me ahimi vela naha me api me compress karada passe. Ekenne ara original sound eke tiyana dewal e vidiyenma apita ganna puluwa. Lossy වගේදී ඒ විදිහට ගන්න බෑ ආපහු ඒක generate කරන්න බෑ මේ දැන් MP3 ෆයිල් එකක් අරගෙන අපිට WAV ෆයිල් එකක් හදාගන්න බෑ ඒ quality එක. ඒ කියන්නේ convert කරන්න පුළුවන් MP3 එකක් WAV එකට convert කරන්න පුළුවන් හැබැයි අර original WAV එකේ quality එක එන්නේ නෑ. Right? And then we have MIDI, right? I'm going to stop at this point. I'm going to stop at this point, and then the next session we are going to do some practicals, right? If there are no objections, so we can choose Wednesday as our first practical session, right? So let me know if your convenience on that, right? And the other thing is, may most probably next week you will be, if everything goes smoothly, you will be. So we will take you to the university, the third years, for the practicals, right? So we it will be informed officially. So now we are making the timetables. So we will be sharing the timetable soon, and then we'll be informed, right? So in the next session, so I will talk about these file formats, and then let's talk about MIDI. It's a something big area, so we'll talk about that, right? So if you have any questions, you can ask. So I'm going to stop at this point for today. Sorry. So I think the problems of LMS are now resolved. So I will upload the notes probably tomorrow, right? And then we can talk further in the session, in the practical session. Right, so if you don't have any questions, so thank you for joining. So most probably I'll see you on Wednesday, so after 3, right? So hopefully I can take maybe 2-3 hours, and we can I can show you some things on the things that I explained theoretically, practically, how those things are handled, how those things are in, for example, like how WAV file can be seen in as an array. So likewise, like we can do many things. So let's see, right. And then. I'll do some practicals with maybe with Audacity, and then with Cakewalk, right? Okay, so that's all. Thank you, and do experiments, right? So do play with what you have downloaded, and then try to do some experiments, right? Try to see how they work, how you can record things, how you can add things, how you can edit things. So those things with your software that you have downloaded, play with them. Okay, see you on Wednesday. Stay safe. Good night.
Sir?
Yes. Yes.
Sir, may data selling download karaganna me api me practical එක use කරන මේ softwares මොනවද කියලා පොඩ්ඩක් හරියටම يعني practical කරගෙන ඉස්සරහට මොන software එකෙන්ද අපි
ඒක ඒක මේ මම එහෙම මේ ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මම ගොඩක් කලවට මම පෙන්නන්නේ කේක් වොක් වලින් හැබැයි ඔය කට්ටිය වෙන සොෆ්ට්වෙයාර් පාවිච්චි කරලා තියෙනවා නම් ඒ ඒ වතර මේ කියන්නේ මේ දැන් මම කරන දේ අනිත් සොෆ්ට්වෙයාර් වලින් කරන්න පුළුවන් ඒතර එහෙම මේ සොෆ්ට්වෙයාර් එකක් මම මේ 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 මේක පාවිච්චි කරන්න කියලා බලගිරීමක් නැහැ ඔය කට්ටිය දැන් දැන් ඔයා පාවිච්චි කරනවා නම් වෙන එකක් ඒක කිසි ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මම මේ මේ දැන් මෙතනදී කරන්නේ මේ මම මේ මේක මෙහෙම කරනවා කියන එකටත් වඩා දැන් මෙන්න මේ වගේ දෙයක් කොහොමද කරන්නේ? ඒකේ මොකද්ද තියෙන මේ අර ඒකේ බෑග්ග්‍රවුන්ඩ් එක මොකද්ද? කොහොමද ඒක මේ ඒ කියන්නේ මොකද්ද එතනදී වෙන්නේ? අන්න ඒක එක්ස්ප්ලেইন කරනවා ඇරෙන්න මේ දැන් මේ මම නිකන් අර කරලා පෙන්නන්න මම කේක් ඔක් පාවිච්චි කරනවා. හැබැයි මේ අනිත් ඒවා ඔකට කැමති නම් පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන්.
ඕකේ සර්.
ඕකේ. ඒ කියන්නේ එහෙම මේ restrictions නැහැ පාවිච්චි කරන්න ඒ වගේ.
ඕකේ සර්. Thank you sir.
Okay, so thank you and okay, good night.